just clap your hands in his presence tonight. Hallelujah. From the rooftops we proclaim it, that Jesus Christ is Lord. Oh, he is Lord over this nation. He is Lord over our lives. Hallelujah. Come on, don't stop praising him. Hallelujah. We proclaim it from the rooftop tonight, that he alone is God. No other God but Jehovah tonight. Hey, hallelujah. Oh, you are mighty God. You are an awesome God. You are my God. He is Jehovah Jireh. He is Jehovah Shammah. He is the mighty deliverer.
Perfect grace has brought me to this place. Because of you, I freely live my life to you, oh Lord, I give. So I stand before you now. I lift my hands, 'cause you set me free. So I shout.
The everlasting God, the everlasting God.
just lift your hands in this place everywhere.
The everlasting God, here I am, here I am. I stand with arms wide open to the one, the Son, the everlasting God, the everlasting God.
Here I am,
I stand with arms wide open to the one, the Son, the everlasting God.
Come on, just worship Him tonight. Just worship Him in this place.
The everlasting God.
Here I am.
I stand with arms wide open to the one, the Son, the everlasting God. The everlasting God.
Come on, bless your God tonight. Come on, bless His name tonight. He's the everlasting God. Oh, He's the balm in Gilead. Oh, the everlasting Lord. Yeah, the everlasting Lord. Come on, worship Him. You want the Lord to prepare you tonight for His service, for His will. Your prayer is, Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary for You, oh God. I want to know You in a real way. Oh, hallelujah. If that's your prayer, just reach out to Him tonight. Just reach out to the Lord. My heart.
Set
Come on and worship God tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship Him. Oh, if you know you're ready to do His will. Oh, you want Him to purify us. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, just praise Him tonight. Come on and praise Him. Praise the Lord. Come on, lift up His name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, we worship you, God. Fill us up, oh God.
Give Jesus a good round of applause. Hallelujah. Give the Lord some praise, somebody. God.
Trinidad and Tobago. We are here for the final night with Prophet Owuor from Kenya, Africa. This has been viewed on Mercy and Truth Ministries. Good evening, viewers. I am Latoya Rock, and I am here reporting live at Globe Auditorium in Port of Spain from the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. We are here for the final night with Prophet Owuor from Kenya, Africa. This is being viewed on Mercy and Truth Ministries, hailing out of Jamaica. It is being viewed in Grenada, Curacao, and the wider Caribbean. We'd like to thank our sponsors, Mr. Basil Hansen, the owner of Mercy and Truth Ministries Television. We'd also like to thank Prophet Owuor and his ministries, Repentance and Holiness Ministries, and Dr. Victor Gill and Reverend Tracy Gill, the co-pastors of Redemption Christian Center. In Dr. Owuor's ministry, healing, miracles, and known works of God has been seen throughout the world. These are nothing strange in his ministry. And tonight we are here to see the wonder-working power of Almighty God. God has sent him to our shores to prove his love and his grace towards us. So we go now live to the stage to continue at this time.
And we wanted to see, because we heard about this revival. And when we arrived there, the first person we interviewed where we were staying at the hotel was this lady who was healed of multiple illnesses. She had something on her throat, and she was completely healed. She was deaf completely in one ear, and she received a creative miracle confirmed by the doctors. She couldn't make a womb. There was a problem with her womb. She couldn't have children. That was healed also. And then she was delivered from demon possession. 5 miracles. They said this is a mega revival and there'll be so many people. We said, well, I couldn't in my mind fathom what they were saying. When we arrived and we saw the crowd of people, the crowd was so massive. People were gathering 2 weeks in advance. People were coming with their suitcases. I wept in the vehicle because I've never seen something like this in my life. And then we were waiting at the hotel to receive the man of God. The whole hotel was dedicated to his servants, his guests who were coming there. So all of this was new to me. This beautiful 5-star hotel that is just for the man of God and his guests. Free. And when the time came to go to the feed, before we went, Archbishop Dr. Njero said, there are now 6 million people on the field. I said, say that again. He said, I am told there are now 6 million people on the field. I said, my God, this nation is just 1.5 million. And so when we saw the field, we were blown away. And then I heard of the amount of pastors under this ministry, 40-something thousand. And all these things. But you know, I could go on and talk about a miracle of the little girl that had no eyeballs, that was open before our camera. This is what made it important. We were there. I saw these things. I had a camera with me. I had a powerful camera with powerful lens that the Lord laid upon my heart to buy. And I took the pictures of this little girl who she couldn't walk. The braces were like a cast on her feet. And the man of God had the braces in his hands, and she was running as if she was never impaired. But the most striking thing to me is the message of holiness. The message of holiness. How could a man in this age be so on target with holiness, unflinchingly, and then have it confirmed with signs and wonders? That to me is a... It only God can do that. I want to say to Trinidad and Tobago, tonight, after the prophet leaves, we have seen the miracles, we have heard the message, we have a responsibility. What do we do from here? It's time for us to come back to God. I am pleading with the pastors. The money message, if a man could come from Africa, no honorarium, Because if he wanted honorarium, I couldn't give him. No hotel fee, no airplane fee. He just comes to bless us. Why can't we do the same? And he's coming from Africa. The Bible says freely you have received, freely give. I believe the gospel is free. We charge money for the gospel. Concert this, concert that. We raised money to buy instruments for the church. How could you raise money for the gospel when you are going against the gospel by the methods that you use? And not to mention the sex sin in the church. Well, I wouldn't want to say much more, but I want to tell you this. What this church has done, Redemption Christian Center, we did it alone. And I'm not complaining. Let me give you this testimony. When I met the man of God in the Ugandan embassy in Nairobi, and he prayed for me, he said, son, your ministry will explode. But he said this to me. He said, do not worry about the money. When I was traveling between New York and China last month on a missionary trip, the Lord spoke to me in a vision and told me, I've given you the privilege to bring my servant here to receive him. Do not make money a problem. The same words. And so I want to say to Trinidad, what we have done, Trinidad and Tobago, this is a gift to you. We give it to you. If you think Pastor Gil don't like you, he's preaching against sin, look, a gift. Man of God, could you come? This is a gift. So tonight I present to you Dr. Onjero. And this is a gift that God has given to us. God bless you, servant doctor.
Thank you very much. Thank you indeed. Thank you, Michael Tran for me this. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you indeed. And the other one, a little bit to me. Thank you. Let us pray as we are still standing here. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty and most glorious name of Jesus. Father, I would like to appreciate you and acknowledge your disposition of love upon the church, that while we were still sinners, you found it right and you deemed it fit to send your one and only Son. His name is Jesus, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Lord, you sent him to the cross without a penny. You did not charge us. You did not ask us to pay you. And you sent him to redeem us by the power of the cross and his blood. For that, I want to stand here in Trinidad and say thank you, Jehovah. Thank you for the mighty miracle of salvation that we mere mortals can now dream about coming to your eternal kingdom. For that we say thank you, mighty Father. Thank you indeed. Thank you that you did not wipe us out like you did during the time of Noah. That you sustained us, you preserved us, and you had patience and tolerance with us until this day. Father, as we meet here tonight, this last meeting, as you remove me from this land, may you establish your revival in this land. May you establish the message of righteousness and holiness in their hearts. May you keep the fire burning until the Messiah comes. May you visit them in ways untold and ways unknown, that they may bear witness that indeed Jesus is Lord. And he is returning for the Holy Church. Father, as we begin the last session here, I know there are many sick people. Lord, visit them tonight. and bring a tremendous fire of your revival into their hearts and use them into this land and keep the heavens open in this land. In the mighty and most holy name of Jesus, amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you indeed. Thank you. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much, everybody here. Thank you. I'm very blessed as we are still standing. I'm very indeed blessed to be here, to have been sent, to get to meet you, to know Dr. Gill, to meet the congregation in this land, the people of God. It is a privilege I can never take for granted, because there are so many. There are 7,000 he could have sent to come here to bless his word. So thank you very much for assembling here tonight. And I ask you to sit in the mighty presence of the Lord for just a short while. Just a short while, precious people, before we go into the healing service. On our last day here, will you sit a little bit? My daughters and my son, you will sit a little bit if you don't mind. Yes, so today we are a little bit even more than yesterday, I can see. And yesterday the Lord visited us in a very tremendous way. Very historic, touching people, physically touching people and removing tumors. Hallelujah. These are the wonderful days. I am so humbled to have lived to see these days, even to hear what the Lord is doing. And indeed, he loves this land. Now, I want to share very briefly before, and then we will just go right away into the healing service, because we are leaving tonight at 3 o'clock. I think we should be at the airport. But now, I want to share this. The Lord came again, God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the creator of all the heavens and the earth and the people, the things, the creation therein. He came to speak with me about those who have just come. Just come. I have not begun. Just come right to the front. There are many seats in the front. Come very close here. I know the Lord heals even at the end, even through the TV. He reaches people. But if you can come to the front, it will help also. So now he came again. Yeah, there are seats. Indeed, there are seats. My daughter, I saw you checking. There are seats in front. Thank you very much. The Lord came again to speak to me about the coming of his son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And in that conversation, the Lord lifted me up in the tremendous dream. He lifted me up above the earth. And when he lifted me up above the earth, then from where I was, I saw the earth. And those of you tuned in your homes, it's a privilege to come into your living rooms with this mighty message of this hour, the message that is announcing the coming of our Lord Jesus. Now, from where I was lifted up, I could see the earth. And when I looked at the earth, come in everybody and sit down. There are many seats in front. Many seats in front. Come to me. I think I need to stop ushering and just minister the gospel, right? Come, there are many seats in front. Thank you very much. They're all for you. They are written reserved and your name is on it. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. So it shall be in the kingdom of my Father. Your name will be written on some chair somewhere as they await your entry into the kingdom. Hallelujah. We are ready. So when you sit down, I'll begin right away. Thank you so much. Thank you indeed. Sit down. Please come and sit. Everybody enter, sit wherever you find. This is the house of the Father. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Thank you now. Thank you. So, well, having sat down, thank you. There is even one seat in front. There is even a seat in front. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you indeed. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, worship team. Thank you. Thank you. Now I begin. So, from where the Lord had lifted me up, I could see. Ushers, make sure you catch this. Ushers, make sure you focus on this as you serve the Lord. I could see the earth. And when I looked at the earth, I thought a massive earthquake had hit the earth. And I know that I go all over the world prophesying earthquakes. So I see them in dreams before I prophesy them. And I was seeing a similar phenomenon touch the earth. I was seeing what looked like a tremendous earthquake touch the earth. Why do I say earthquake? Because I saw the surface of the earth shaking and the rocks jumping off the surface, the rocks, and the dust coming up like that. Then I thought this must be a historic earthquake that has hit the earth. So from where I was looking at this earthquake. I knew this is an earthquake. This must be big. And then all of a sudden is when I realized this was not an earthquake. Why? Because I saw that from where I was, there was the glory of the Lord coming from somewhere in the heavens here. And the glory of the Lord hit the earth. It is the glory of the Lord that hit the earth. And when the glory of the Lord hit the earth with such power, earthquake power, it is the glory of the Lord that began, just come in, everybody coming in, there's so much room, there is everywhere, many seats here. Let me continue with this, focus on me. So the earthquake, something like an earthquake, then I realized, no, this is not an earthquake, because I saw the glory of the Lord beam from above and hit the earth. And then I saw people in their glorious bodies, people in their glorious bodies come out of the earth. The tombs of the earth, the dust of the earth. And when they came out, the glory was so immense on the surface of the earth, and the dust, you remember the dust was up also, the dust. So as they came out in their glorious bodies, the glory and the dust were mixed. So I saw them live in their glorious bodies from there, and you can imagine how slower he must have slowed it down for me to see it like that. Because the Bible says in a flash, in the twinkling of an eye. So I saw them come in the dust, the glory and the dust, and they were pulled. They were being pulled, attracted by the glory of the Lord. And so I have some news to bring here to you, that indeed it is the glory of the Lord that will open up the tombs on that day. And so as they went up, I saw that they now went into, just come in, everybody come in, we have just begun. I see a lot of people flocking in. There are seats in the front also. Yes, in the front also. That's very good that everybody's coming in. Tonight is very busy here. Hallelujah. Let everybody come in. There is room for them. Allow them, release them quickly. Protocol. That they may not miss this. Hallelujah. I know we are live on TV, so I need to do it straight actually, without stopping. So what happened is that as they left the dust of the earth, then I saw them go into the pure glory of the Lord. And then they were caught up with the glory of the Lord, and the cloud covered them in. I would like to share two things. First of all, they were not pulled just from wherever to above. They were all pulled to one particular corner of the earth, which I know of, where there is a portal, an open portal. They were pulled towards one corner, and above there, they were pulled up and they went. And then the voice said, and I think this is the message here, the voice said, and the majority of them have remained in the dust of the earth. And I think that is the message. And the majority of them have remained in the dust of the earth. So I want to share a little bit on that. And then I woke up. So when I woke up, as usual, as we have shared in the conferences, I said that whenever the Lord Jehovah speaks, you and I have to be able to encounter it in the Bible. In fact, we have to be able to line it up with scripture. And once you do so, then that is where the message is. Hallelujah. And I said also the failure to line up what is being said left and right with scripture perhaps is now coming out very clearly as the root cause of the fall in the church. Because he's saying that the Bible essentially is the mirror, is the balance, is the scale that should be able to tell us when the Lord has spoken and what he has said. And so when I woke up, of course, I went to look for it in the Bible. Then I found out that he had shared the same with Daniel, the end time prophet of Jehovah. And when he shared this with Daniel, Daniel found out that this was so important, and he recorded it. He documented it in Daniel chapter 12. And I found out also later that he had shared the same conversation with Isaiah, the glorious prophet of the Lord. And when Isaiah received this message, then Isaiah, yeah, thank you so much. Thank you. So when Isaiah received this message, Isaiah recorded it. He saw that it was so important, and then he documented it in Isaiah chapter 26. And so, what is the message then that the Lord is dispensing? Very briefly, as we plan to enter into the healing service just now, very briefly, in the next 5 minutes or so, what is the message of the Lord to the West Indies, to this precious community, precious society in Trinidad and Tobago, the blessed people that so dearly love Jesus? What is the message the Lord is dispensing to you regarding this conversation of the rapture of the dead? How they will come out of their tombs and go. Number one, we get to understand that the Bible says, when you read several scriptures that actually celebrate the coming of the Messiah and the events that accrue on that day, the day of reality, the day of truth, because that is the day when we will know the truth. We will know who was really a Christian on that day. Who was really a Christian and who was really a holy Christian. And so, I want to mention this right away. That the Bible in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 14, it says, make every effort to live in peace with all men and to be holy. And then he says, for without holiness, nobody gets to see the Lord. That nobody will see the Lord. And so right away you begin to understand that the most important message there was that, and the majority of them have remained in the dust of the earth. Meaning, now, these that he has taken, I don't want to use the word few because I want everybody to really aspire to enter. But these that have been pulled out of there must be the Christians that at their point of death were walking in holiness. But that is the truth. That is the reality. At the point of going to sleep, the Bible says they fell asleep. At the point of going to sleep, they must have been walking in holiness. And number two, I also began to realize that some people have remained down there. So when I went into the book of Daniel chapter 12 to understand the message I should bring to you, then I found out that Daniel characterizes, when the Lord spoke with Daniel regarding this, he characterized it into two phases. Two phases and two sub-phases. Two groups, but two subgroups. The first phase, Daniel speaks about the events prior to that event. And he talks about the great unspoken distress that will consume the earth. And I understand this distress because Daniel says, like has not happened unto the nations from creation. I understand this because I have been going all over the world prophesying these tremendous distressful events right from the Haiti earthquake here and all the way to many others now in Nepal, the bloodshed in the Arab world, the global economic crisis, and many, many, many events. I have been involved in this. And so really I understand what Daniel was seeing about now from then, from that time seeing. But most importantly, Daniel uses that now to tell you that that is a demarcation on the prophetic timeline of God. Meaning, those are signs, in Spanish, señales. Those are signs that you were supposed to watch for. But when you look at the prophecy of the four apocalyptic horsemen, which I prophesied also, all the release of them thereof, everybody, we have seats in front. We have two seats in front also. Amen. But when you look at the prophecy of that Jesus gave regarding his own return, then you find that surely, yes, he talks about these distresses that would be able to mark for us, to make the church different from the rest. Meaning when you watch your news, you use your spiritual eyes and say, ah, for me, I know that this speaks something to me. For me, I know that this speaks about the coming of my Lord. In fact, to the extent that Luke says, when you see these things happen, then you raise up your head, for your deliverance is nearer. And so what I want to bring to your attention now as we finish this, so we can go into the healing service, is this. When Daniel writes that, when you move to Daniel chapter 12, verse 2 now and verse 3, Daniel sees the same conversation the Lord shows me. That Daniel sees those who are asleep in the dust of the earth wake up, meaning they are not dead. They are just asleep, being woken up. Wake up, wake up. And sometimes you want to ask yourself, who wakes them up? How do they wake up? Because you know there will be a trumpet. There will be the voice of the archangel. One of those will wake them up. As in, wake up, guys, it's morning. You see that? Hallelujah. So let me just go into the message here. So look at this now. Daniel sees that he sees two resurrections. When it is near, when the event is near to happen, the Lord shows me one resurrection. Daniel sees those who are asleep in the dust of the earth will awake. Some to everlasting life, others to shame and everlasting contempt. So look at that now. Daniel sees those two. Sometimes when the Lord speaks with you in these dreams and visions, he can put them so close. He puts them very close. And sometimes you don't want to mess up the dates. So you just rather say them as they are. Otherwise, if you say that the Arab bloodshed is going to come, the rapture will happen and the Arab bloodshed will come, people might, you know, depending on how you say it, they may not prepare. I know this. I'm talking about this. For example, when he showed me the rapture of the church and the bloodshed you see going on here, it was too close. I had to be very careful to make sure I don't say they wait for the bloodshed first before rapture. I had to be careful with that. But what I'm saying, Daniel saw those who are sleeping in the dust of the earth awake. And he says, some to everlasting life, some to condemnation. Now look at this. Among those that are resurrected for everlasting life, Daniel sees that there is a subgroup. And he says, those who are wise will shine like the brightness of the heavens. And he says, however, those who lead many to righteousness, like the stars forever and ever. We know the heavens and the stars normally shoot out. Meaning, Daniel is saying that, look, the people going to heaven were those who are bright like the heavens and those who are like the stars. In other words, Daniel has revealed the message therein, and that's why the Lord has sent me here. To ask this nation one question, that now that the Lord has already shown me this, I need to finish this for the healing service to begin. Now that the Lord has spoken with me about this and sent me here, then the question is this. Are you aware that the Lord is saying that this is the hour of wisdom in the church? The hour of wisdom in the church. And when you go to the book of Job, even Proverbs, you see, the book of Job, chapter 28, if you start reading from verse 20 all the way to verse 28, it will tell you, you hear him discussing wisdom. Wisdom, he talks about wisdom. And he asks, where does wisdom live? And then you hear death, destruction and death saying that even us, we don't know where wisdom lives. Only a rumor of it has reached our ears. Meaning those who are beholders of the wisdom are also hidden away from destruction and death. That's what he's saying there. And that's why, for example, on such a night you are here and not drinking in some club somewhere where maybe a fight will arise and destruction and death meet you there. You are hidden in the word here. And so listen to this. Daniel says, when you read this, then he says, those who are wise. Meaning, when the Lord now shows me this, he shows me those who are resurrected for rapture, for the kingdom of God. And he is essentially asking Trinidad, the West Indies and Tobago, is asking you, ever since you became a Christian, have you really bothered to check out whether you are walking in wisdom? in the wisdom of the Lord. Because he tells us from that book of Job chapter 28 all the way to 28. And he says, 28, says, behold, it is the fear of God that is wisdom. You understand? So in other words, the Lord is saying, is this generation that is born again walking in the fear of God? Because time is also run out. Time has run out. So he sends me here to ask that very important question. Are you really walking in the fear of God? Because if you're walking in the fear of God, you would check everything you do and ensure it is right. Because you fear the Lord. That means before I take this phone call, I want to ask, will I be offending my God or blessing my God? Before I take this job, before I go to do this, whatever. So you'll use that as a standard gauge for your life on this earth. I'm trying to rush and finish so we can go to the healing service. So the Lord is asking, ever since you became a Christian, are you really walking in wisdom? Are you aware that this is the hour for the church to be wise? And Jesus himself says, and the wise virgins enter. Wise, meaning fear of God. Listen, precious people. He's saying also, when he moves on, he says, and those who lead many into righteousness, like the stars forever and ever. So the question then becomes this. Ever since you became born again, or you became a pastor, have you really led people into the righteousness of the Lord? Remember, the only way to lead people into that righteousness is by you evangelizing it, meaning the way you live your life. That is the evangelism he's talking about. And so, you see very clearly that he's saying the wise and those who lead many to righteousness will go, but they will get different prizes. Prizes. Like he's talking about the judgment seat of Christ. And then he's talking about the coming of the Messiah and the taking of the church. And if you read the Bible in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 16, 17, he essentially says that there will be a chronology of events before on the day. If you look at the dynamic, the mechanism, he says, those who are asleep in the dust will come first. They will resurrect first. And then taken, and then as they go up, you that are still alive at that time will be translated, the holy ones. Not all Christians will go to heaven. I want to announce that here. Not all Christians are going to heaven. Only the holy Christians will go to heaven. That's why we have a real opportunity here to adjust our lives to fit the standards, the benchmarks of the Lord, right? And now, I want to ask this. In some of the things you've done, even as pastors, have you really led people to the righteousness of the Lord? Because he says, like it was during the time of Noah, so shall it be at the coming of the Son of Man. But we know that at the time of Noah, people did not like righteousness. And look at this now. Ever since I came here, and now I'm finishing with this message that we may go into the healing service. Ever since I came until this night, I have been building an ark. I have been building an ark here, and I've been calling you, calling upon you. Please join me. Let us build this ark of righteousness. Let us build this ark of righteousness before the doors, its doors close. In the time of Noah, nobody paid attention until the day landed on them. The day he fell, it fell on them. And then the door was shut. And the Bible tells us that the Lord himself, Señor mismo, the Lord himself shut the door, not Noah. Because Noah has that emotional makeup. He could have probably said, oh, whose voice is that? Oh, that's my neighbor. He used to share salt with me. We used to share bread. Open for him. But the Lord himself, no emotions. Meaning on that day, no mercy on that day. It will be totally inexcusable that you have not prepared. That's why this event, as we begin the healing service tonight, I want you to contemplate these things. I want you to think about the most important message in your homes, those watching on TV. Think about even the visitation that's about to take place here. Yesterday we saw the Lord touch people. Today he's going to touch people here. But think about this message too. Ask yourself, ever since you became a Christian, have you walked in the wisdom of God, the fear of the Lord? Ask yourself, that ever since you became Christian, a pastor, evangelist, whomever, ever since you became part of the household of God, have you really led people into righteousness? Or maybe because of your conduct, many people have run away from the Lord's righteousness. For example, if you are a young man and you are born again and you have been out there doing things with the girls in the university, wherever, wherever, has that really led people into righteousness? And that's why I'm saying this is the hour for inventory, stock taking, to take stock, that we make sure that we don't fool around with our salvation anymore. It was purchased at a high price. The Son of the Living God Himself. And the Lord is saying that, like it was during the time of Noah, the door was shut. So shall the door shut. I have seen the shutting of the door. I have seen the earth after the rapture. I've seen the earth after the Messiah has taken the church. That's why I'm going all over the earth, telling them, hey, I have seen the door shut. Be careful now. How about you here? And so that is the message of the Lord, precious people. Those of you, hallelujah. Those of you who want to receive the Lord, I'm ready. The worship team is in place. I'm ready to take 1 minute of prayer. And then, yes, as we slowly begin to enter the healing service of Jehovah. Hallelujah. What a tremendous time in the history of the church. And so, those who can, only those who can stand. I'm not saying everybody. Those who can stand, please stand. And those who want to receive the Lord or to be right with the Lord, you know your condition. I have done my work, but you know your condition. And this is yet another wonderful opportunity to be able to go before the Lord and just surrender our hearts as we slowly go into the healing service tonight. And it's very blessed to know that at this hour we can share the message of righteousness, the most lacking item in the church. Hallelujah. And so those of you who want to receive the Lord, don't fear. Remember, Jesus died on the hill. He died in the public place on the hill, that everybody may see him dying for you. And I remember when the Lord showed me that dream of how Jesus died on the cross. It has sent me running and weeping and crying across the globe until today. And I know that he gave his all. He gave his best. He gave everything, that one day you may not be put to shame. Those who want, lift up your hands very high so that I just repeat this prayer. So repeat very loud if you can. Say, precious Jesus, I surrender right now and repent from sin and ask you to forgive me and establish your word in my heart and my life and ignite my heart with fire. The fire of the Holy Spirit. Precious Jesus, maintain my name in the book of life of the Lamb of God. Precious Lord, beginning now, I begin a new walk in the mighty name of Jesus. I am born again. Amen. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah. What a mighty way to begin the healing service. Allow me say this. Now, if you know that you have been in sin and you were born again, but you've been in sin, I want you to know that there are pastors here. Just make sure that you fulfill all righteousness. Jesus was baptized and he said, it is proper for me to do this to fulfill all righteousness, that when that day comes, you don't be found not to have fulfilled all righteousness. So make sure, if you understand that if Jesus was baptized, how about you? There are pastors here lay your hand on a pastor and tell him, Pastor, please baptize me, that he may baptize you, that you may be right. The Bible says nobody knows the day or the hour. When we prepare now, that is a significant investment we make into the future. Remember, however beautiful, however enjoyable the West Indies, Trinidad, Tobago is, the barbecue, the good food, the good streets or whatever, the beaches, whatever. Look at this now. After 300 years are over of your life, if the Messiah did not come, you may not be here. And yet, if you go into heaven, after 9 billion years are over, eternity has not yet begun. So it's always worthy to invest into righteousness, because righteousness is imperishable. That is the only thing that makes the difference between Christianity and all the other religions. That for us, we are the beholders of the righteousness of the Lord, and our shelf life, our sell-by date is written eternal. Hallelujah. I want to sing here before we start the worship song together for the healing service, as we slowly go into the healing service. I want to sing unto the Lord here alone, without the keyboard, just alone. Just turn it off now. I just want to sing before the Lord here because of how wonderful he has been. And in this song, I want to glorify the old rugged cross, because I know it is by that old rugged cross that many lives are going to change here tonight. Hallelujah. And the old rugged cross made the difference in a life full of sadness and defeat. And I will praise him forever and ever for the cross made the difference for me. Can I continue? And I'll praise him forever. Without keyboard. But the cross made the difference for me. Let me repeat it again one more time. I would like to love the Lord with this song. And this is the old rugged cross that will change lives here. People will walk here. You will heal people here. And the old rugged cross made the difference in a life full of weakness and mistakes. Full of weakness and mistakes. And I will praise him forever and ever. For the cross made the difference for me. One more time. And I'll praise him forever and ever. Thank you for joining me. Everybody join in. And the cross made the difference for me. One more time together, and then we go into the healing service. Oh, the old rugged cross. The new gospel of prosperity does not like the old dirty rugged cross. The new gospel of prosperity, just a moment, does not love this cross, because at the back of the cross, when it was like this, a lot of blood there, blood stains there, is dirty. It's an old, dirty, rugged cross. And because people are modern today, they want modern gospel, modern things, new things. But I'm telling you that the hope for the church, The future of the church, you are healing tonight, is coming from that old rugged cross at Calvary. Hallelujah. Yeah. Join me now. Full of defeat.
And I will praise him forever and ever. For that cross made that difference for me.
One more time.
And I will praise.
Hallelujah, the cross. Thank you very much. So can I sing hallelujah worship song? So as we go into the worship song slowly by slowly, we're just going to sing hallelujah as we slowly walk into the worship service of the Lord. There is a drum that normally hits very powerfully with hallelujah. Yes, so. Listen to me, everybody, now. Listen to me, everybody here. The precious members of the family of Jehovah, my God. Listen to this now. I know that many things have happened in your life, probably. And sometimes they have been very painful. Sometimes you have felt like you are alone. And that you're walking this long road alone, and many bad things are happening unto you. Sometimes you have evidence of that. You have disease. You have a situation that testifies to that. And sometimes the doctors have their own writings on that situation. They also have their nomenclature, their naming system. They can call it carcinoma. Sometimes they say incurable. Sometimes they use the word chronic. They use many words. And sometimes it hurts. It hurts to be in that condition. And I know that tonight, as we are gathered here in this place, as we begin this healing service, there is one thing which is about to happen here. This place is going to change a few minutes from here. There is going to be a tremendous change here, and many people are going to be visited by the Lord here. Hallelujah! In this place. This place, let me repeat this. This place is going to change. The Lord is going to visit his people, and he's going to touch disease. He's going to establish his mark on your life. He's going to say, you belong to me. You are mine. I care. Hallelujah. Listen, precious people. I want to say this. Even those who have come, you are not yet late. We have just begun. Listen to this. Focus on me now. At this place, I want to say the following. That regardless of the specialist, regardless of the consultant, regardless of the medical documents, the condition you see with your eyes, I want to make an announcement here that none of those things will matter anymore. From now, beginning right now, baby, beginning right now. Beginning right now, I am saying that even what you have known, but beginning from this moment here, what will matter is one thing, that the blood of Jesus is still flowing and healing people. And setting them free from sin. That is all that will matter here tonight. I thank God that the blood of Jesus is still flowing. And that is what will bring healing here tonight. Let me just listen to how it's going in the background. Somebody's going to see. Hallelujah. Somebody join me very lightly so we can catch this. Listen, precious people, I'm going to say a prayer here. It's going to be a very short prayer. And then after that, many things will happen in this land. The Lord is here to love you. He's here to visit you. This is our final night here. But he's willing to touch each and every person with need. And that is the greatest news about this God that we have. He is always available at all times. So I'm going to say a short prayer. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, I lift up my left prophetic arm towards your throne in heaven. And Lord, I come before you and your mighty counsel to speak to you, my Father, the God of our Lord Jesus. You who is the God of Abraham, the tremendous God of Isaac, the terrible God of Jacob. Father, look, today we are gathered here. And in this sacred assembly, my Father, there are people that are sick here, Jehovah. There are people with different conditions here, my Lord. These people love Jesus. They have just received Jesus. They have just acknowledged that they love him. They take him now into their hearts. And Father, now I stand before you and ask you, my God, to come down here and remember the cripples in this place. You who created the legs, may you fortify their legs. If it is the hip or it is the waist which is broken, may you touch those places and strengthen their legs, that they may walk for the glory of Jesus. Father, in this place there are blind people. Mighty Father, you have shown me already in the dream that you are opening blind eyes. In this place, I ask you, my Lord, to spit on the ground and touch the blind eyes. Touch the blind eyes that they may get to see your glory. They may get to see this moment, this historic moment in the church. Lord, open the blind eyes that they may see you. You did a tremendous job yesterday in that department, my God. When you open their eyes that they may read your word so well and bear witness and testimony of this hour. So open the blind eyes of the babies, of all ages, even the aged. My Father, in this place there are deaf people. I ask you, my Father, to pop open their ears. Pop. Let them not open in a light way, but pop open, that they may know you have touched them, Jehovah. That they may hear your word. That they may hear your announcement of the coming of the Messiah. Father, touch the tongues that are dumb, that they may be loosened, that they may praise the Lord. Father, I ask you to remember the lame. Stretch their legs and step down. Throw away their crutches, my God. In the mighty and most glorious and holy name of Jesus, I ask you, my Father, to stop the bleeding diseases, to touch the broken backs, to touch the broken knees, to touch the broken hips, to touch the spinal cord injuries, to touch the broken necks, the broken skulls. Dissolve the tumors, my God. Dissolve the cancers from their bodies in the name of Jesus. My Father, I ask you to remember the wombs that are blocked. Remember the women that are going through distress and sadness. You can unblock their wombs tonight. You can put a smile into their faces. My Father, I ask you to remember those who have cysts and dissolve the cysts also from all over their bodies. Lord, I ask you, Jehovah, the internal organs, from the kidney to the liver to the hearts and everything else that you know. Let the blood of Jesus flow over their bodies, my Father. Let the blood of Jesus flow over this place right now, on this ground as holy ground, in the mighty name of Jesus, and so shall it be. Amen. Finished. Finished. It's over. It's over. Finished. 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 There is no more prayer. There is no more prayer. I have spoken unto the Lord. In Kenya, normally I don't pray. I just walk in. I walk in with the Lord. So listen, precious people. Right now and here, I lift up my left prophetic arm towards the Lord and ask you to receive your healing right now.
Everybody receive your healing now. Try to do what you could not do. And once you can do it, shout to the ends of the earth that I may celebrate with you. I have raised my prophetic arm towards Jehovah. Those who are crippled, who could not walk, try to get up and walk. Broken hips, broken everything. The Bible says whatever he says. Whatever happened, shout to me wherever you are if you have been healed. I am lifting up my left prophetic arm towards the Lord. The Bible says whatever he says, just do it. This is the moment we have been waiting for. The deaf, the blind, make sure you pass something in front of them. And once you have received the miracle, please shout to me because of time. We don't have much time here tonight. I can't hear you. Everybody put down your hands. That is the easier way. Only those who have been touched by the Lord, lift up your hand. If you know he has touched you and you cannot do, remember, you make sure you can do what you could not do. Someone is shouting somewhere, right? The Lord is already visiting here. Hallelujah. Everybody receive your healing right now. If you can see, let me know you can see. Tremendous things are happening out here, right? Everybody receive your healing. Only the ones who have been healed, lift up your hands. Only when the Lord has touched you, then it's easier for me. The deaf, check if you have a deaf, try to do like this. If they turn like this, that is the moment for you to shout and let me know. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus is still flowing here. Everybody receive your healing now. If the Lord has touched you, please let me know. Because I know there's quite a lot of work going on here now. Even the babies. Over there. Thank you so much. Remember, you may not help them. Let the Lord help them. The tumors also, touch where the tumors are because of time altogether. The tumors where they are. If you don't find it, let me know. The Lord knows you.
My Lord.
Talk to me, my son.
This woman.
Yes.
Had a cancerous tumor in the belly, but the Lord dissolved it. It has disappeared.
Just now there.
Yes, my Lord.
We have begun the healing service. Somebody clap to Jesus. I told you, Jesus knows you. Wow. You mean it happened there? It happened right now.
Yes. Last night, and I was doing it sometimes.
Yes.
This is my lungs. I never used to smoke.
Can you tell me about what happened? Because I need to get to people here.
I just felt something burning.
Something burning.
And this morning I got up and I told the people I am living, my neighbors, that there is no more pain there. The tumor is in the lungs. Yeah. Well, I still have to go to my doctor.
You must go. Thank you so much. Just be here for a moment. Then let us clap to Jesus for that. Tremendous. Everybody receive your healing. The blind people here, the deaf people, the mute. I am still lifting up my left prophetic arm towards the Lord. If you can do what you could not do, let me know. I know there are some people sitting here, they are not even trying, but the Lord loves you. If you can do what you could not do before, please shout to me so I may know where you are. Receive your healing, everybody, now. There are no deaf babies here. The Lord commanded the deaf ears to pop open here. The blind, if you can see, shout. At least you can say something. The Lord knows you. What diseases are here? I think these are crippled people, broken hips or something. The Lord is saying, do what you could not do. Wherever you are. Remember, we have just begun the healing service. And it's going to be big here tonight. I've seen people healed here. The blind, can you try to see with those blind eyes? The deaf ears, I've already commanded you to open in the mighty name of Jesus. If there are deaf people here, try the babies. The Lord knows you. The tumors. Only those who have been touched can lift their hands so that I'm able to call you in the front. Have you been touched? Thank you. Then just walk, make your way slowly to this place. Thank you so much. I clap to Jesus for that. Everybody, receive your healing now. Receive your healing right now, everybody. I want you to do what you could not. If you could not walk, I want to see you walking in the name of the Lord Jesus. What has happened? Can you press that? Can you, somebody help you with the microphone? Everybody receive your healing. Look, I am still standing before the Lord. The most important way to do it is to try to do what you could not do. If you could not hear, thank you so much. If you could not hear, and you can hear, I will dance with you.
My Lord!
Talk to me, Bishop.
This lady here.
Yes. Can you move away from the speakers? Yes, thank you.
Would not stand up.
Can you come then? That would be a big one though.
She could not stand up for two minutes.
You could, hold on a second. You said what?
To be helped.
You could not stand up for 2 minutes.
My legs will collapse.
Ah, no. This is a big thing that has happened here, right? I told you, I am going to call the people that brought you here. Hold on. Make sure you are here. Make sure there's somebody standing next here to help me. Thank you. She's there. She has come. Just be near here. Always be near. Thank you so much. Yes. Don't touch her. Just leave her. That's amazing. That's very powerful. We are going to talk here. We're going to call the people that brought you also. What has happened to you, my daughter?
Hi. Good night.
You know her. Okay, there you go. Everybody receive your healing now. The miracles have begun flowing in. Thank you so much. It's well. Just watch. Make sure you watch them. Yes. Okay. Everybody, wherever you are, this is the last evening here, and the glory is here. The healing anointing of the Lord is here. There is a woman, you look at me with your eyes. You open your eyes wide. I know that. You open your eyes wide and you see me. Where are you? I don't know what your condition was. If you have a baby that is blind, try to pass something before them. The Bible says, whatever he tells you, just do it. Hallelujah. No deaf people in this congregation? What a blessed nation then. You know, I go all over the world, I see you. Oh, amazing, eh? It's big here, but let us receive our healings right now. Everything has begun. Remember, the healing service has just begun. We are here in the name of the Lord Jesus, that he may be glorified in this land. What are the conditions? Okay, can we start with tumors like yesterday? Are you coming down? Okay, can we start with tumors? Are there people with tumors? I know you have a tumor, and I cursed death Even in the night, I continue to pray for you. I cast death with my tongue. Yes. If those with tumors, thank you so much. Those with tumors, if you can touch it and feel it, you know yourself better. If you can touch it and feel it, the best place to start is where you can feel it. Touch it with one hand and lift up one hand so I can also see you where you are. Those with tumors. If you have a tumor, touch it with one hand and lift up one hand so I can see you and know you. Because there are no people with tumors here, right? It's a blessing. You're a very blessed population, right? We always have to thank God for that. How about those who cannot walk? The healing anointing of the Lord is here to help you that you may get up and walk in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive your healing now. Just make sure you watch her. Thank you. You don't hold her, but just watch her. Thank you very much. Receive your healing, everybody. Those who cannot walk, rise up in the name of the Lord and walk. Don't help them. Let them walk by themselves. I will worship here like yesterday, and the Lord will be touching people here. As we worship, receive your healing. Can only know if you can do what you could not do before. If you had a tumor and that tumor has dissolved, can you speak to us? I have commanded all the tumors to dissolve in the name of Jesus. If you had a bleeding disease and it has stopped, you need to go check first and then come. And remember, here we also sometimes send you to the doctor to verify. Hallelujah. Running out. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now I'm asking, wherever you are now, no deaf people here? That's always a good thing to ask, because sometimes it's important for them to hear the announcement. How about blind people? Open your eyes and see. And if you see, please speak with us. We want to celebrate this. They're mute. Okay, they're mute. I know you are in the Western Hemisphere. Sometimes it's better health care on this side. But they're mute. Okay, anything. Anybody that has been touched, tell me. Only these two? Are there sick people here? Rise up and receive your healing. Rise up and receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Oh yes. Rise up and receive your healing in the name of the Lord.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, remember these people. Lord, I ask you to flow the blood of Jesus over them and raise those who cannot walk. Give them strength and power to walk in the name of Jesus. Give them a testimony, my God. And Lord, I ask that if there are any blind and deaf, touch their eyes. Establish your authority over their lives. Establish this hour in their lives, that they may know that you are visiting the church in these days and loving the church and setting men and women free. Father, touch even the babies and the tumors and all diseases under the sun. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Receive your healing, precious people. I have only two now. Talk to me, my daughter. What has just happened there? Okay, the pastor is with you there. I think the Lord has touched somebody right there. Next. My hand is still up. I see. My hand is still up. Only two people tonight. I take two also, but I want more. No tumors here tonight. How about the crippled people, broken hips? Nobody should help you, remember that. Only the Lord should help you. And the Bible says, whatever he tells you to, just do it. And then it will be a tremendous celebration in the kingdom. Okay, then I'm going to take the two testimonies. I cannot stand for more than for 2 minutes. But you've been there for some time now. Just try anything then. I have nothing else to tell you now. Try anything then. Whatever it is, you will see or hear. Let me take these testimonies here as we begin the healing service. Babies are healthy here. The babies are all healthy. Thank you so much. My daughter, I see you stretching your leg. So talk to me. Who brought this person here, first of all, to begin with? I want, first of all, to know her names. And then I will find out what the condition was. You know her, right? Now, we are in front of the television cameras here. And I want this testimony to go right into the living room right now. I know the Lord is going to touch more people here. He's going to heal more people here at this hour. But as we talk this, I want you to speak it to people who may not even be here tonight. We're going to take the two testimonies. Tell me, what is your name, my daughter?
I am Kai.
Kali?
Kai.
Kari. From where?
Dego Martin, Trinidad. Dego Martin, Trinidad. Dego Martin.
Rigo Martin, Trinidad. Is that part of this town?
No, it's west of this town.
So it is far away. You came to this place. How did you make it here, first of all?
Well, they had to help me into the van. And they had to help me out and to get a seat. And every time I tried to stand up to pray, my legs say, And
is that how you were doing?
Yes. I went to clinic last week and I fell a couple of times. I couldn't make it to the clinic.
Are you telling me how your legs?
My legs wouldn't let me. I just started falling. I was totally embarrassed.
Can we go step by step? There's no embarrassment in being sick. You know, the devil comes to destroy. There is no embarrassment in disease. So don't worry. You may have fallen, but there's no embarrassment. Because sometimes Jesus takes that and uses it for his glory. Right? So what I want to ask is this. Who brought you here to begin with?
My neighbor.
You are a neighbor. What's your name, my daughter?
Sandra.
Who?
Sandra.
Oh, Sandra. So where did you meet her? Do you know her before?
Yes, neighbors. We are neighbors.
has been her condition?
Well, she has
I think we have a camera somewhere, right? That's why I'm trying to do this.
Okay. Yes, she has a kidney problem. Had a kidney problem and a thyroid problem. And it was causing her to, well, she didn't have energy. She was weak. You know, she was...
What could she do?
She had to stay in bed.
Thank you. For how long? For how long has she suffered this? I'm coming to you. Let me first talk to her. It's okay, my daughter.
From December? A few months. Some months.
Yes, and you said she could not stand? She could not walk?
Not by herself. She needed a little assistance.
By who? Two people? One person?
One. Yeah.
And then you decided to bring her here. How did you hear about this meeting? You know, there are people watching in their living rooms. I want to reach them also.
Actually, it was my husband that heard of it and invited her to come. Yes. Larry.
You decided to talk to her about the meeting, right?
Yes. So we came on Sunday afternoon.
On Sunday afternoon? The other Sunday. Oh, okay. Thank you.
Well, it didn't have any deliverance service on that day, but we decided to come back today.
But tell me, you used a vehicle to bring her here. Yes, the process of putting her into the vehicle?
Yes. To get some help. She had to get some help to come in. She just couldn't walk on her own. She needed a little help. She needed a little assistance. She didn't have the energy. You know, her legs were weak.
But she's telling me that she could not stand for 2 minutes.
No, she couldn't stand for long. She couldn't sit for long either. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Sandra. Now, I would like to talk to you. And again, we are focusing on some cameras here, which are home, plus these precious people. I want the Lord to touch more people here, that we may celebrate the whole night here tonight. The last meeting, we need to dance to the Lord here, because these are already big things happening here that prove that the blood of Jesus is still flowing. 1 miracle is enough, but I need like 100 miracles here, because time is out. You understand? But this is powerful already, beginning in a mighty way. So talk to me again, your name. I'm sorry, I'll ask again.
My name is Kai. It's beautiful in Swahili.
Thank you so much. So you said she helped you to come here. Can you describe to us what she did, how she carried you to the vehicle?
She held one under one arm, and somebody will hold me under this arm. And I have to try to get enough energy to lift my legs, to put it in. I'll have to get in there as quickly as possible, because my weight wouldn't allow me.
The Lord has performed a big miracle here today. No, we have just begun the healing service. Anybody needing a miracle here, don't worry. We have just begun the healing service in a mighty way, in a very mighty way, live on TV. Talk to me. There is no editing here. Hallelujah. Then you gather some energy and put the leg.
Yes, I walked out of myself.
And so tell me, can I move a little forward now? When the Lord touched you, when was that time and what did you feel?
When he said to stand up.
When I said stand up?
What you can't do.
Hallelujah! I said, when he's... No, I'm coming, my daughter. I said, whatever he tells you, just do it. Hallelujah. Oh yes, this is very powerful, because she's saying that you say to stand up, do what you could not do, and then she tried to stand up and she found that she could stand. We have begun the healing service. I know she's burning with a miracle, right? I'm coming to your miracle. Hold on a second. We have just begun. Don't worry.
Hallelujah.
Talk to me, my daughter. You're vomiting now. Thank you. Thank you. You're vomiting now. Let her vomit. Mighty deliverance. It's well here. The Lord is here. It's all right now, my daughter. It's okay now. Someone needs to cover it with some tissue, right? Thank you so much. Listen, precious people. This, my daughter here. How awesome today. Oh, yes. The Lord has helped you. He has helped you today. That is it now. Wow. Come. Thank you so much. Just cover it. Everybody receive your healing now. The Lord is delivering people from disease, from sickness. The blood is flowing. Talk to me, my daughter. Let us sit next to the minister right there. It's okay, just sit. Continue sitting, your honor. Just continue sitting. She's well. She's only being set free. We need some tissue there so she can vomit on the tissue. If she wants to throw up, let her throw up on the tissue, not on her clothes. Give her some, help her with tissue, even wet tissue also. Your honor, you can sit down. Thank you so much. Today is your day. He remembered you. Look how much deliverance. Hey. Wow. Everybody receive your healing. Thank you for the tissue helper. Receive your healing. I'm coming to your miracle. Don't worry. Jesus of Nazareth is setting people free right now. Have you thrown up enough now? Or you still feel like... Are you okay now? Or you're still throwing up? Okay, put the tissue down there, I guess. Some tissue in here. Thank you. Thank you. What has happened there? Talk to me.
My Lord.
Talk to me.
This woman had a lot of pain in her legs, and she has used a lot of medication to try and control the pain in vain. But
for how long? For how long? Huh?
For years I've been taking painkillers to ease the pains in my legs and my feet. I cannot walk without them.
How much pain?
Extreme pain. I had sciatica nerve pain that kept me in bed for three months, about 2 years back. And when I walk very painful, just to put my feet down. And I walked halt. Up to yesterday in class, I had to lie down because I was going to get painkillers for me. I couldn't walk. I was supposed to come here last night, but due to family responsibilities, I couldn't come. And a sister from church brought me here tonight. And when you were speaking and you said you lift up your left hand, I felt a warmth in my legs. And I sat down.
Somebody clap to Jesus.
I sat down.
You sat down.
Because I wanted to know if really and truly I said, Lord, I need this so that I can be able to do your work. And I sat down and I was moving my knees and I realized I wasn't feeling any pain.
I saw you doing things somewhere here.
Sitting right here. And I got up and walked. So let me walk.
I saw you
and
walk
see.
A little bit up
yes.
there.
And when I walk, I realize there's no pain in my knee. There's no pain
okay,
in my
now
arm.
Come and talk to me. Watch out. Just watch out. My daughter, I'm coming to you. It's mighty today. You have been set free today. Look at that. Big deliverance today. And the healing service has just begun. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. You are saying the nerve problem, you call it?
Yes, sciatica nerve pain. I had it about 2 years back, and it had me in bed for 3 months. I couldn't walk.
Oh, that's terrible, yes.
When I started walking, I had to live on painkillers. I was mixing painkillers just to be able to stand up and walk.
Well, mixing painkillers. Which painkillers were you mixing?
Motrin, Advil, Tylenol, you name it. I was taking it. Up to yesterday, I said if I could get Motrin, morphine, I would take it.
Even morphine? Okay, that's now the end line.
I said if I could get morphine just to be able to walk, I will take it because I want to be able to walk and do the Lord's work. And I was in class yesterday and I had us to lie down because I wasn't able to stand up to do anything. They had us to go and get painkillers for me. And this morning I do something. I got up and I went to class and I tell God, I said, Lord, you have to do something.
That's very powerful that you did that. What happened here tonight?
I was standing there when we started, the healing service was going to start, and I was saying, Lord, do it for me. And while I was...
Lord, do it for me.
Yes.
Somebody said, Lord, do it for me.
Lord, do it for me.
Thank you.
And while I was standing there, I felt a warmth in my legs. So I do sort of say, okay. And while you...
You felt some warmth in your leg?
In my legs, yes. And then I do sort of say, I sat down and I started touching my legs. And you know, I said, well, it have air conditioning here. So if I maybe it's not about standing. So, but when I moved my leg, I realized I wasn't feeling any pain, any joy.
Let us clap to Jesus right there. So much pain that she needed to mix painkillers to walk. People need to walk here today. The Lord is here. So tell me, I saw you get out from there and start to do like this, like this. Can you explain to them what you're doing?
When I realized I wasn't feeling any pain, I said, let me get up and walk because I know once I start to walk, the pain kicks in. And I realized I was walking and the knee feeling like, you know, when you're puppet and the knee just moving. And I just couldn't believe it. So I said, I'm going to walk up because I know walking up give me a tendency to give me a bit of trouble. And I walked up and I came back down and I realized there's no pain, no more pain.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You have taken one from the teeth of the devil and brought her out. Now the issue is, tell me. Thank you. Hey, wow. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you. That's very mighty. Oh, yes. I don't know what to say. She knows what she has gone through.
No more painkillers. No more.
Why are you crying?
Because I know what I have been through.
Why are you crying?
I have so many painkillers at home. Painkillers are taken at night. Painkillers are taken at day.
Not anymore.
Not anymore.
Not anymore. Not anymore. Hallelujah. Come, my daughter, come. Come, let us walk. Let us walk. Look at the people that did not walk. She has been delivered here in a mighty way. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Hey, everybody receive your healing. She knows what she's been through. I want to see blind eyes open, says the Lord. The crippled, where are the crippled? Wow. You will walk. Because these are signs that the Lord is doing work here. And the healing service has just begun. It's the last night, so I can stay here. I can move from here to airport, right? There's no problem about that. Yeah, because That doesn't matter to me, as long as the Lord can reach people, right? Can you come, my daughter? Because I have feedback from the mic, from the speakers. Talk to them. Yes.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. All I want to do is to be able to do the Lord's work to live for Him. And I'm being crippled by this pain often. Sometimes I can't even go to church. Sometimes when I get up off of my bed, I can't even walk. I just have to be able to try and even to sit on the toilet and get up. It's a problem. But today I go on, Lord Jesus.
Jesus is Lord. Those watching on television, He can visit you in your home. Maybe it's your day to receive your miracle, and it's free of charge. There is no money down. The healing service has just begun, and the blood of Jesus is already flowing. come, my daughter. Wait. Thank you. Oh yes, thank you. So I'm going to leave you a little while and go to her. But just talk to me. What are your names, my daughter?
My name is Margaret Abraham.
Margaret Abraham.
Yes. I am from La Hoqueta Arima. I came here with some members from my church. Amen.
Did they know that condition?
Yes, they know.
And one, just one, because of time, one person that knew this condition. Can you come and talk to us, please? That we may magnify Jesus. So nobody in your church is here? No one is here to celebrate with her? Come out then and run.
Sister Megan, where are you?
Hey. Come, my daughter. Sister Megan. Thank you so much, my daughter. Thank you so much. Are you born again? You heard I was rebuking tight clothes in church? Yes, tight clothes like that, I was rebuking them, yes. Yeah, because for me, I stand for the Lord. I don't know anything else. Yes, only the Lord I stand for. But that's all right. That's why He sent me, that we may rectify our ways and go back to Jesus. It's a great love that I'm here and that I've met you, and we are here celebrating righteousness, the hour of righteousness. But anyhow, look at what the Lord has done.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. I thank God for what He has done.
So you knew her?
Yes, I.
How do you know her?
From fellowship in church. From church.
Which church? What's the name of the church?
Cornerstone Christian Center in La Hoqueta.
Cornerstone Christian Center. Now, what did you know about her condition?
I know that her legs pain her a lot, and sometimes she had to miss Bible study and prayer meeting because of the pain in her legs.
That's very tough. That's very mighty what the Lord has done today. And even you now, even you here, even you everywhere, you can receive your healing now. The Lord can touch you in major ways. And thank you so much. Can you just hold on here, because I normally keep you here a little bit, because I will also give you instruction. I will first use you to celebrate the glory of Jesus, and then, amen, and then I will also send you back to that doctor that he may receive the Lord. So talk to me, my daughter. We were talking here when it happened to you, the deliverance took place here in a mighty way.
Well, I also was diagnosed with tumors, and they say that was responsible for my kidney failing. So I was on heavy antibiotics for months and painkillers. And I didn't want to say that I feel that I claimed the tumors, because I didn't know what they felt like. But while standing up there, I just felt like I wanted to vomit. And I thought, oh my God. And I have an appointment on the 15th.
That's very powerful.
Firm that those tumors
have gone. In the name of Jesus. In fact, I was about to tell you to go back to your doctor.
I am also going to go back to my doctor to let them know my kidney has not failed and is whole. Yeah.
One patient, two records.
Because while I'm standing here feeling kidney stones acting up and they're moving, and I say, oh no, Satan, you're a liar. I claim an all tonight.
The glory is here.
Yes, glory.
And now you have been able to stand for so long tonight, right?
I thought you might have just prayed and I would have got my healing and sit down there. You know, I had no idea what was going to happen.
Everybody, I'm coming to you, my daughter. I'm coming to you right now. Receive your healing. Where are the deaf people and the blind people? They are not there. In this land, you have no deaf people. May the Lord visit you in a mighty way, all of you. Even the women with bleeding disease, you can go and check. If the Lord has not healed you, we just continue praying. Hallelujah. The crippled people. Okay, I'm lifting up my hand and praying for everybody. It doesn't matter the condition. How about up there? Mighty Father. Father, remember these people and those who cannot walk. Help them like you have helped this lady here. You can strengthen them, Jesus, and give them power to walk and glorify you and testify you. Lord, help their babies also. Help whatever condition they are suffering from, whether it's blocked wombs, bleeding, diseases, it's tumors. Dissolve them, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. If you have something, shout from where you are that we may know where you are. Reduce it a bit. If something has happened to you, shout to me. Otherwise, I'll close the meeting. My daughter, what has happened to you? Your name is first.
My name is Cecilia Crouch.
Cecilia Crouch.
And I am from Las Lomas, number one.
You're from where?
Las Lomas.
Las Lomas.
Yeah.
Is that in this town, around this town?
Piaco side. It's going up on here.
Thank you so much.
Less than a year ago, last year, my mom passed away with cancer. And I was diagnosed. She died in August, and I was diagnosed in November, the early part of November, with the cancer. What was happening to me is my left lungs, I used to get tired and shortness of breath. And I went to a specialist, a lung specialist, and the left lungs was filling with fluid. And when they sent me to Montauk to drain it, that's when the doctor saw the tumor on the lungs. But the doctor told me, he said, I do not want to get you your hopes up. It could just be an ordinary, everyday tumor. So they took a piece and they sent it for a biopsy. 3 days later, a little before Christmas, they called me into the clinic. And that's when they told me it was stage 4 cancer.
Thank you, my daughter, as well. So I just want to know one thing. When you came here today, you were here, sorry, yesterday, what happened to you here?
When I was leaving, my son is here with me.
That's your son?
Yeah. I got a sincere burning, you know, like when you rub pepper on something, how it is burn. I told my friends that I came with yesterday. Michelle, Mr. Howell, can you stand, please?
Thank you. Yes, thank you. Can you tell us what happened?
Yeah, I felt this burning, and I told them, I said, no way, I feel in a burning. And the gentleman told me, I am being healed. And when I went home and I lay down, I dropped asleep, there was no pain. I used to get some serious pains. And last night, I went home, I sleep, no pain. Got up this morning, play with my neighbor's dog, just as I usually do every day, and there was no pain.
And the tumor. Thank you so much. And the tumor. How about the tumor?
Well,
because when you came there, the announcement that was made there that you had a tumor that dissolved.
Yeah, it's dissolved, but I'm going to go to my doctor.
You must. I was going to send you there.
And I'm going to let them check me over.
But I just want to know how you feel about that tumor.
It's not there. I'm not feeling anything. But to be on the safe side,
You must go back to the doctor. Yes, and then have two medical records so that the glory may be bigger. And those with HIV AIDS, also let the Lord heal your blood in the name of Jesus. HIV AIDS also. May the Lord heal your blood. In Kenya, when that happens, they go to doctors and they examine. So we have two medical records for one person. For the glory to be greater and bigger. But just that she felt, sorry, my son, this is your mom, right? Just share with us in a very short time because I need to pray for more people. What happened? What did she tell you yesterday?
I just want to give a testimony on my mom. She has, as she said, she has stage 4 cancer. And just a year and a half, my mom was on a flattened bed, couldn't move. We used to do stuff like mom and son. We used to go out. My mom, I thought my mom was going to die, but that almighty man above, as we just quote said, he healed my mom in many different ways, and today she's here still with me for at least, she mine, as I could say, she here with me for 16 years. She brought me up as a kid, and I just pray every day to God that he have my mom still alive, healthy and well.
Thank you. What happened to your mom yesterday?
She said she felt like a burning in her chest, and when we went home last night, she lied down and she said she's feeling no pain, and this morning she gets up.
I curse death in the mighty name of Jesus, and I decree the blood of Jesus. thank you so much. Thank you indeed. Yes, it's well. People get healed of cancer, people get healed of HIV AIDS and all blood conditions, diabetes, hepatitis, hypertension, and everything else. What has happened here?
My Lord, this woman had arthritis and a lot of complications, pain in the knees, and she could not walk without a walking stick.
Where is the walking stick itself?
She says she had faith. She comes from Jamaica, so she told the daughters, I leave the walking stick that I may go to the meeting of the Lord and walk.
Where are the daughters?
They are here.
Thank you so much. Where is the daughter to this woman? Come. I don't have time. Can you come, please? Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing. Your daughter is a pastor, right? Oh, that's amazing.
We all come from Jamaica.
Is this your mom? Is this your mother? Thank you so much. Thank you.
My mother has been suffering with... Praise the Lord. I am a pastor in the Baltimore altar under the Repentance and Holiness Ministry. My mother has been suffering from arthritis for a long while. I haven't been to Jamaica in a long while, but I know she's been using a walking stick. And at one point I sent a prayer request to the man of God, and she received relief, but I know she was still having pain because she didn't talk about it much, but I could see her tapping her leg from time to time, and I could see her limping when she walked. So I knew she was still having problems. But as she said, this is something I just learned when she just said it just now. Just now when she was sitting right there. Because she said, I have to go up. And I said, are you sure? I said, let's walk up there before you go down. And she didn't obey me. She walked straight down.
What couldn't you do then? What couldn't you do?
Today is 3 days I'm here. Because of my daughter. And when she called me in Jamaica, I said, I can't come. Then my other daughters from England, she came with my grandson, they brought there. And I said, I don't want to go. She said, Mom, you have to come. So I said, I'm sick, I'm not coming. I said,
Mom, please. So I delivered and answered.
Thank you so much. What couldn't you do?
But God is the glory. Oh, Jesus. What a wonderful Jesus. Today, yes, that's not when I came to church with her. I was in pain. I didn't tell her nothing. And this morning when we woke up, she said to the three of us, Mommy, we want to baptize you. I said, I'll baptize already in the name of Jesus. But she baptized all three of us. And we're going back tomorrow. But God is on the job. I'm a high potential.
I want to ask you a question. Because of time, I need to pray for people here. What happened? What couldn't you do that you can do now?
I don't know. I just sat there and I just feel that God tell me to get up.
Tell me, what couldn't you do when you came with your arthritis? What couldn't you do? Kneel down, do what?
This was when I walk, it was like it gone up. Can't stand.
How were you walking before? Show the people here. Show them how you, yeah, just show how you walked. But now, how do you walk now? Walk straight. We see my daughter. Thank you so much. Okay, now I'm praying for everybody else. For every miracle, we glorify the Lord. I know the Lord has done big things here and tremendous things over there. Why do you keep going there? Come, my daughter. So now, precious people, wherever you are, whatever the condition, the Lord can still heal you now. People have been touched here in a tremendous way. The Lord can still stretch those hips, those joints, whatever they are, that you may walk in the name of Jesus. These are the days when He's visiting the church. And you are that church. He's looking for a testimony from you. The blind also and everybody else. And if you know there is a condition somewhere that has been touched, the Lord knows you. I do not know you. Once you are touched, shout there that we may celebrate before I bring this to a close. Wherever you are. If it was a bleeding disease, you can check. Nobody touched over there? If you're touched, lift up your hands then. I think that's the better way to say it. The deaf, the mute, the paralytics. I cast death in the name of Jesus. That the blood of Jesus may flow over your life. That you may live because He lives. Thank you, my daughter. Hallelujah. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, help these people. Help them in whatever condition. Lord, build them so that revival may visit their hearts, this land, and the church. Lord, as you've touched these ones, you can touch all of them. You are more than able. That this land may be known as the land whose God is the Lord. Lord, that they may go on with this revival and affect all the other nations around here. Lord, let righteousness remain in the hearts of these people. That over and above all, they may see the kingdom of God, the eternal kingdom of glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. If you have been touched, let me know. Remember what I said, baptism, the pastors are here. Touch the pastor, make sure the pastor baptizes you. That is the greater glory. That we may fulfill all righteousness, just like Jesus did. Let me just worship a little bit in case the Lord will touch somebody before we finish up. What has happened? Remember obedience. Once the Lord commands righteousness, Please obey. Because that is for eternity. Your revival is in righteousness. Thank you so much. So I think this is sufficient for tonight. And may the Lord bless you and bless this country, that you may see revival, that when the nations will assemble, your country will also assemble, that the people of the West Indies will assemble, Trinidad, Tobago will also enter the glorious kingdom of Jehovah. For every miracle, I say thank you. The Lord knows where he has removed his people from. And they are going to go back to the doctors, to the doctor, to get the records, and the pastors are here. They come back to the pastors there. Those who need baptism, please make sure at least you register somewhere before you step out, because that is eternity. Let us fulfill all righteousness. And some of you, like we are now hearing here, you might reach home and find that the Lord has touched you. And if that is you, the door for glory is still open. Come to church and testify. Remember that glory belongs to Jesus. Already the Lord has begun in a mighty way in your country. People have been touched here from yesterday until today. People that could not stand for 2 minutes have now stood. And the evidence of their deliverance has been out there. Standing longer.
I think I got more than I bargained for, because I got a message on Sunday and I thought that was enough. But I've seen the power and the glory of God today. So, glory to God. Glory to God. The message is sufficient to bring it back. Amen.
Thank you so much. You got more than you bargained for. Why don't I want to leave you people? Because I should have gone out already. There is something magnetic about this country, right? But revival has come. The message has come. The announcement of the coming of the Messiah has arrived. So prepare. Join Dr. Gill. Join Dr. Gill so that this revival can explode, become flames. Join him. One church did this. 10 churches can do this next time. And remember, the instruction of the Lord is very simple. The Lord is instructing a national repentance in this land. I don't want to lose focus on that. Even despite all this, national repentance. Kenya began with a national repentance. Repentance always cleans away sin. Repentance always prepares a vessel for the Lord to visit. Hallelujah. Remember national repentance. The churches must come together, the government, and then one day is put aside when everybody goes before the Lord and repents before the Lord. Hallelujah. That is the explosion of revival. That is the day that explodes revival. And those of you who are healed at home, I mean, when you get home, please contact the pastors. Again, those who don't have pastors, there are pastors here. One pastor can stand up and shout his phone number. That will still work, right? One pastor can stand up and shout his number, right? Before I leave. To make sure the harvest enters. Is there a pastor in the house? Any pastor in the house here? Any pastor here? Can you shout your number to them? Because some of these people may go. Your phone number. Thank you so much.
2292.
If you have a phone, 09. I think they are removing their phones. Just give them a moment. Give them a moment. They are removing their phones. so that we can consolidate the games.
All right. Let me give the office number and you'll call it an office time. 225.
Almighty.
6-7.
Almighty.
8-7. 225. 6-7-8-7. And for after hours, you can call 797.
797.
57.
57.
54.
54.
So that's again 2-2-2-6-7-8-7-7-9-7-5-7-5-4.
Thank you. The Lord bless you, Trinidad and Tobago. We'll see you in the kingdom of God. If I don't come back, I'll see you in heaven. Remember righteousness.
We have changed your presence in the church. The Lord wants to be. Then change your presence. No sons, daughters, no presence, no glory like Jesus.
Good evening, viewers, and we are here at the end of this conference with Dr. Owuor. Many have been healed, many have testified about tumors going, about the changes that God has done for them. We have come to the end of this conference, and we thank God for what He has done at this time. We'd like to thank our sponsors, Dr. Owuor and his team, Repentance and Holiness Ministry, Reverend Dr. Victor Gill and Reverend Tracy Gill, the pastors of Redemption Christian Center. And we'd also like to thank Mr. Basil Hansen, the owner of Mercy and Truth Ministries Television. You can stay tuned right here on Mercy and Truth Ministries Television as they go to their scheduled program. Good night. God bless you.
He knows you. Sometimes you don't have to do something that's happened, but share with the pastor. There's never been, I'm not healing for 4 years,
but when it came, avalanche. The Lord bless you, shalom. Jesus loves you.
Amen. I want to say this. I was in the healing service last year. While the man of God was coming to the field, cripple got up and walked before he arrived. And almost a year after, a blind person was listening to the testimony of the meeting and their eyes pop open. And I believe many of the miracles that have been announced will continue in our country through our ministry. This is the miracle of God. Amen. And we're going to have a follow-up service right here. I believe it's Sunday coming, and we will tell you more about it. But I want to tell you, I make no apologies for saying it's time for us to move on in righteousness, holiness. So many of us have been following people. This is what a man of God said when I was in the Ugandan embassy. He said, you have been following people who have been taking you to hell. We want to go to heaven, and I am telling you, this is no gimmick, this is no play, this is no money, this is no hype. And you have leaders here who are ready. I know many of you cannot, you say, I can't come to Love Until because, but a man of God came there. Nothing happened. I've been there for 26 years and nothing happened to me. If you believe in Jesus, we are there, 36 Esplanade Street, but we are coming right here also to have some services. Listen, call the number and we are going to be here because now we connect with repentance and holiness. And if you want to go to Africa and see the revival, there's no charge. Just get your ticket. The man of God will put you in a hotel. He will feed you. Come on, let's be a part of this. Let's overthrow the false prophets and go to heaven. Somebody say, yes! So I don't want to say much. I give God all the glory. But I believe the healing will continue. I don't want to say nothing. I don't want to promote myself, my ministry. But if you want to live for God and go for righteousness and you don't want to go to hell, then I'm telling you, this is your time. Father, we give you praise that we could have been instruments in your hands. I bless the people as we close this service. I thank you that the testimonies will continue, that we will hear those that couldn't walk, those that were blind, the anointing that lingered on the bones of Elijah for hundreds of years will linger in this nation. And pastors that are here, ministers that are here, this same anointing will begin to flow through their ministry. We declare a new paradigm. We fire the false prophets that are coming with false fire. And I'm telling people, $15,000 for miracles, $10,000 for miracles. We say a new day has begun. Could I get a witness? A new day has begun, Trinidad and Tobago. We must not go on the same platform with Marshall Montano. We must come out of carnival. Some of you don't like that, but it's the truth. I say we must come out of carnival. Come out of the Calypso tent and stop dressing like hookers, woman. I give my church until the end of the year to change some of your clothes, because I know you might not have money, but come on, let's begin to do it right. I don't care if you criticize me. I rather err on the holy side. And look at that, you're like, you don't want to go home tonight. I better call back the prophet yet. Lift your hands and let's just worship God. Thank him. It's not about us, it's about Jesus. As we go, thank him for Trinidad and Tobago. Do you realize the prophet came at a strategic time in the political history of our nation? You know, on the first night he spoke against idols and he said they are coming down. This is God's timing for healing. Somebody praise the Lord. Somebody say Jesus. Jesus. Say Jesus. Jesus. Say Jesus.
Jesus.
Say we take back Trinidad.
Take back Trinidad.
We take back Tobago.
We take back Tobago.
We take back holiness.
We take back righteousness.
We take back purity. We fire the false prophets. We fire the money gospel. We fire sex in the church. We are getting ready for the rapture. God bless you. God bless you and all the pastors, the government minister, Roger, the honorable, my good friend, Roger Samuel. You know, when he came into government, the night God told me he's put him there to speak to the prime minister. So watch your tongue. I can't talk much about that. But God bless you. Have a good night. We love you. From Redemption Christian Center, from Repentance and Holiness Ministry that I'm now connected with. Jesus bless you.
You deserve the glory and the
all the men of Redemption, we want to meet you in the front here. Don't leave. We want to pack back the stuff. All the men. So don't forget, call our number 252 6